What's up, legends? It's your boy Earl Shatter here, and in today's video, we're going to be taking a look at the ICR. Something a little bit different today. We're going to only be using one grip. If you guys are familiar with the best class setups that are recommended all across YouTube, you will know that everybody recommends you use double grip on the ICR. Honestly, it's what really makes this weapon stand out to be what it is. It is a no recoil, basically machine. This thing can destroy opponents. The key thing is hitting shots. If you do not hit your shots with this gun, does not melt people very quickly, is going to be hard to win gunfights, things of that nature. So obviously, taking a look at using only one grip is going to let us know if this weapon can be used with any other class setup successfully, or is grip 2 just overrated? Is that something you actually need? We're going to find out today in this video. Now, before we get into the rest of the video, if you guys do enjoy this content at any time, make sure you show your support for the channel by going down below and smashing that like button. Let's go ahead and throw that goal of 50 likes on today's video. Also, if you guys are interested in finding a way back to the channel, make sure you guys do hit that subscribe button alongside that notification bell so you don't miss out on any future content. Now, originally when Black Ops 4 launched, the ICR was one of the most powerful ARs in the game. The double grip, plus the fact that it had a pretty decent damage, was just extremely hard to beat in gunfights. People were basically hitting every shot, regardless of their skill level, of course, just because of how low the recoil is on this weapon. It was just a little bit too strong. Since the launch of the game, they have obviously made some tweaks. They've changed some things. I feel like this weapon is fairly balanced across the board. Now, you can take people out quickly, but it does require you to hit your shots. I think they've even tweaked grip 2 just a tad to make it a little bit less impactful on the recoil. But now you do feel like this gun truly is a little bit more balanced. One thing that hasn't changed for the ICR throughout the life cycle so far of Black Ops 4 would be the best class setup. Typically for the best class setup, you guys are going to see grip 1 and 2, probably on all of them. Everything else might change just a little bit, but pretty much across the board, people essentially are telling you the only way to run this gun is to have double grip. So today, I wanted to go out there, I wanted to take this gun, I wanted to change this class setup, and it's honestly something I haven't done in a very long time. So I decided, instead of running two grips, I ran grip one. We do have the long barrel, and we're also using FMJ. I find FMJ to be pretty, you know, convenient, especially because I run into a lot of people with body armor. It kind of helps me feel like I can take them down in reasonable time. Then we threw on the long barrel just because we're changing things up. I wanted to see how that would affect this weapon as well. First thing I want to say about this class, not using the grip 2, is that it actually was surprisingly a good class setup. Obviously, if you're going to have a hard time hitting your shots, you're going to have a hard time with this weapon because it has a little bit of a longer time to kill due to that low recoil. However, if you are somebody who is fairly good at controlling the recoil, not having grip 2 isn't going to be absolutely detrimental to you. You're actually going to find that you can use this gun pretty, you know, efficiently overall. I will say though, having long barrel on my class, I really didn't notice it. I could probably switch that out for quick draw or even swap that out for extra perk. If you're wondering if you're going to notice a significant change in recoil when taking off grip 2, the answer is going to be no. You're not going to notice a huge amount. It'll feel like the ICR actually has some recoil. It is very slight. In my opinion, it is very easy to control. So I was able to be pretty successful with this class setup, regardless of having grip 2 on or not. I will say, if you're one of those people who is having a hard time hitting a lot of shots, or you're just not super consistent, you are going to notice a significant difference between having the grip 2 on or off, and you will have a hard time getting kills with this gun. After running the ICR for a few matches without grip, and also accomplishing these gameplays, I noticed something just a little bit strange. It actually took me a few matches to realize it, and I kind of, you know, paid a little bit more attention as the matches progressed, but without grip 2, even if you're very accurate with this weapon, you're very, you know, capable of maintaining the recoil, you feel like you're hitting your shots, you're aiming at people, you'll end up losing some gunfights that just kind of seem confusing. And what the reality is it looks like your bullets should be hitting on target, but something about not having grip 2 doesn't allow all of those bullets that appear to be hitting the target register. So it seems like some of the bullets do not actually register while using only one grip, and it kind of made me a little frustrated because I did feel, like I said, felt like I was hitting a lot of those shots, felt like my shots were on target. I would start getting hit markers and then I would strangely die instead of getting the you know, the final shot off. And it just seemed like there's something about not having grip 2 on that affects the hit registration of the ICR. Let me know down in the comment section below, because I'm actually curious if any of you guys have gone out there and tried an ICR class setup without grip 2 and noticed anything strange with the hit detection as well. Other than the questionable hit detection from time to time, I overall really enjoyed trying out the ICR with only one grip. Now, if I was to recommend anybody to use this setup, I would tell them obviously, if you're having any issues hitting your targets, not going to be a class setup for you. And even if you're trying to throw together a good ICR class setup, I would still recommend the best class setup over this one. This is kind of if you just want to try something different, kind of see what things are like, see why certain attachments are really suggested and why people say that they're absolutely a must. This is one class setup you can definitely try. Like I said, you will absolutely have good games with it. There will be times where you completely dominate, but if you're familiar or very used to running grip 1 and 2, you will notice that slight, you know, change in your gameplay or just being able to be super consistent with this weapon, because it's just not consistent without that second grip. It just has that weird hit detection. I feel like if it wasn't broken, it would be super effective, but that's probably why they have grip 2 on this gun and pretty much not any of the other weapons out there. The other gun that does have grip 2 is the GKS, and as you guys are familiar with, the GKS, in my opinion, kind of has a similar feel to the ICR with one grip. Sometimes it feels like bullets don't register. It kind of takes, you know, a little bit longer to kill somebody with it. Overall, when you're making your class setups, you're looking to optimize that class to its best ability. So running the best class setup with this weapon is still going to be the way to go. We didn't find out anything better. We didn't discover a secret class setup you should be using. Reality is, running grip 1 and grip 2 is the best bet for the ICR. Not going to bash this class. I did have a fun time using it. I did notice the long barrel wasn't super efficient, like I said earlier, so we could have switched that out for something else. But today's focus in today's video isn't about how good the long barrel is on the ICR. It's whether or not the gun is usable or is better without grip 2. I will say, grip 2 is absolutely a better option for this weapon. But by no means is this class setup bad. You can absolutely dominate with it. The gun is actually usable without grip 2. It's just really going to all depend on your aim. If there's a weapon out there you guys would like to see a video on without a certain attachment, let me know down in the comment section below. I would love to get that out for you guys. And I'm also interested in what ideas or possible guns you guys would come up with and what attachments you would leave out. The conclusion is, in today's video, that you guys are absolutely going to want to continue running that grip 1 and grip 2, unless you guys don't mind having a little less consistency in your gunfights, but I'm pretty sure we all go out there, we all design our class setups to be the best they can be. And that's going to wrap things up for today's video. If you guys did enjoy this content at any time, make sure you guys go down below and smash that like button, as we do have that goal of 50 likes on today's video. If you guys have any criticism or any, you know, recommendations for the channel, make sure you guys leave those in the comment section below. And if you guys are interested in finding your way back to the channel, make sure you guys do hit that subscribe button alongside that notification bell so you don't miss out on any future content. I do appreciate you guys tuning in to today's video, and I will see you all in the next one. Peace.